Hey guys, welcome back to another episode on How to Hack. So now we'll look into the last tutorial on SQL Injection intro. Okay, so this is about compromising confidentiality with string SQL injection. Okay, so again, we are on WebGoat, which is a vulnerable web application system that we'll try out all these different kind of attacks on. So we can see on the left side, all these are the different tutorials that we'll be doing as part of our web application penetration testing series. So compromising confidentiality with string SQL injection. All right, so what is string SQL? So this is the payload that goes in to the input form and we are trying to break into the system. All right, so here we have an employee named John Smith. Okay, so they work for a company and we have the current TAN. So TAN is a unique authentication. All right, so here you can think of it kind of like a password or a one-time password that is sent to your mobile devices as you authenticate to the different parts of a banking app of a system. All right, so over here we can see the query, the structured query language. Select all from employees where last name equal, and then they have an input name, and then followed by authentication underscore TAN. All right, so again the input information over here. So for example, if I enter the last name Smith, or I can copy and I can paste Smith over here, and then followed by the TAN. So go ahead and paste it. And when we click get department, alright, we are able to see, alright, we are getting the username, the first name, the last name, the department, the salary, phone number, and so on. So we can get all these different details, right? So what we are trying to do here is to retrieve all employee data from the employees table. So how can we do so? Alright, so over here, okay, once again, going back to the previous tutorial about SQL injection, alright, I already have the payload for us. So all we gotta do, right, is to be able to pull out information and records of the system. Okay, so that's what we can do as part of the attack, okay? So over here, alright, what we will do is to put, for example, OR 1 equal 1, okay? And this will help us immediately get the whole information out of the system, right? So we'll continue to have the authentication field over here. And all I gotta do is to enter the following, okay? I can copy this part, this segment, and input into our payload. So what we are doing is a single quote, or, okay, 1 equal 1, followed by semicolon. So 1 equal 1 is always true. So go ahead and click department. All right, so we can, for example, get rid of the semicolon, okay, or the single quote again. All right, so it says, you have succeeded. You successfully compromised the confidentiality of data by viewing internal information that you should not have access to. Well done. Okay, so once again, we're able to pull out the entire table, all the rows of information, and on one of the previous tutorials, one of the lessons, we actually added in an extra column phone, alright, into the database system. So we can see the username, the first name, last name, department, salary, and all these different details again. Okay, so once again, going back to the basics, you have two input forms. So do test them first for susceptibility to SQL injection or to different kind of payloads. So you need different kind of payloads already available. And a lot of these payloads are available out of the box together with Color Linux that you can just input into the system to test out whether they are sanitizing the input or not. Okay, so that's how we actually run the attack. All right, so we got the employee name, we got the authentication. All right, so and of course you can map it back to the structured query language here, or you can build it on your own. Think about how they are developing the web application system to actually pull out all these different records and how they check for all this different table information, all right? And then after which, you can create your payload to inject into the system. All right, so now let us continue, all right, into lesson 12. Okay, so we have compromising integrity with query chaining. Okay, so again, CIA, confidentiality, integrity, and availability. Confidentiality meaning that can someone who is unauthorized be able to view confidential data, financial information, in which they have no rights to access to? All right, integrity is about changing the data. How are we monitoring changes to the database system or to the file systems? And finally, availability, is it subjected to denial of service attack? Can we shut down the entire system? All right, so those are the different kind of traits of CIA, which are the fundamentals of cybersecurity. Okay, so SQL query chaining allow us to add additional instructions into the query. All right, so rather than just pulling information out, can we do further different types of structured query language to inject them into the web application system? All right, so once again, we have Smith. All right, I can copy the information here, and I have the TAN, which is authentication DAN, click Get Department. All right, so we are looking again at the normal way of how it works. And we can see over here, we have the user ID, first name, last name, department, salary, of 10, all right, and phone. Okay, so we can see all these details of employee name, authentication, and so on. So of course, what we are doing, as you have seen from the previous lesson, okay, what we can do is we can inject information into the input forms. All right, so I already have the payload here. So what we can do again is to copy the following. Okay, we can copy the following and I can paste it and I'll explain to you what it all means. All right, so first of all, we are closing, okay, the password and or 1=1, which is always true, okay? Or you can just close it directly. And then we have the following command. We have update, all right, which is a structured query language. And we have update employees, all right, so we're updating the table employees, right? And we are setting the salary, okay, to a specific number. So we're setting it to 85,000, okay? And then we have where user ID equal, okay, to this specific user ID, which we have over here, right? So once you have all these different details, you can go ahead and click Get Department. Go ahead and click on that. And immediately, we're able to firstly pull out all information of the table. And secondly, we have updated, all right, the system with a new salary number, as you can see over here. All right, so we have updated Smith's salary number. So that's how we are able to violate the integrity segment of the CIA trial. Okay, so let's go back up and go into the final lesson, lesson 13, which is compromising availability, meaning can we shut down the database system? Can we drop the table? All right, so that no one has access into the system. Okay, so over here, what we are saying is that now that you're the top earner in the company, but do you see that? All right, that seems to be access log table. So access log actually stores all these different changes to the database, and it actually locks down all those things so that it can be used for audit purposes and to look back at what happened to the changes in the database system. So first of all, we have over here drop table access log. So we can copy this, and let me explain to you what this payload means first of all. Okay, so firstly, we're entering a percentage sign. Okay, so this would actually help us complete the query. Okay, and then after that, we are ending the instructions here. And then we have a semicolon, and then followed by a new instruction, which is drop table. And we're dropping this specific table access underscore log. Okay, so this will immediately help us see all those details. And of course, before I even do drop table, I can actually enter, for example, select all from access log to perhaps even view information inside this particular table. Okay, so we can actually go ahead and enter that, and this would help us see some details about the table. So over here, we can see all of the queries that have been sent into the database system. So we have select all from employees. Okay, we have all these different details that have been sent over into the system, and over here we can see this particular log, right? So we have select all from employees, and then there is a update employee set salary $85,000. Okay, so immediately we're able to see the log file. Okay, so what we'll do next is to actually just copy, all right, the payload and just paste it over here. So what we are doing instead now is drop table. So this would get rid of the entire access log table, and then followed by double dash at the end. So double dash at the end would actually comment out the rest of the query and allowing us to actually run the attack against the system immediately. Okay, so go ahead and enter search logs, and now we can see that we have deleted the access log table, and that way compromised the availability of the data. Alright, so once again, I hope you have learned something valuable in today's tutorial, and remember to like, share, and subscribe to the channel so that you can be kept abreast of the latest cybersecurity tutorial. Thank you so much once again for watching.